Now, here we are to have a look at a pair of nylon strung guitars. A close look indeed. First one is a non-standard. It's a thin-bodied instrument. And this is an Ibanez, wait for it, GA5TCE-AM. Little preamp on the side there, with volume, bass, middle and treble. No tuner, just bog standard basically, but quite adequate. We'll hear that in a few minutes. First of all, I'll play it acoustically. You're just hearing it through the mic with nothing added. When I do the pickup, there'll be a wee bit of reverb on it because I reckon that's the typical thing that you're going to do anyway when you're recording. So, first of all, what does it sound like? If I just play a little finger style. Now that was just an A minor shape, starting in the normal position, then up two frets, up another two, and finishing with an A chord there. Or you could bar the A, if you so preferred. It sounded not bad. It's quite a well balanced sound, it's very pleasant. What does it sound like when you go up the neck? This tends to be the test of any guitar. Most of them sound not too bad down the bottom end, but when you ascend to the dizzy heights, what happens? Well, what does the intonation sound like? Individually that sounded not too bad, but if I put a chord across the 12th fret with three fretted strings, three open strings, what do I get? Alright. But that one sounded a bit off, didn't it? That's the E shape on the above the 12th. Yes. So possibly a guitar for you if you're happy in this part of the neck here, which actually I am, I very rarely go up the top end. This guitar came to me with a bit of a problem in that the neck was going back, it was curved back from about the 5th fret. Now normally what you would do is, on a guitar like this that has a truss rod, you would loosen the truss rod and wait a bit and eventually the neck comes back into true. Unfortunately, didn't it work, did it? No, it didn't. So plan B, a set of hard tension D'Addario strings, so it has a bit more pull to it, and a high saddle at this end, rather than the original one that was in. Now that's made it very nicely playable in this area of the guitar. A little awkward up the 12th, but actually classical guitars quite often have a high action up here because of the low tension of the strings. When you pluck a string, it's like a skipping rope, it goes round and round and round, and the 12th fret is where the maximum amount of movement is, so you have to keep the string clear of the fret there. Okay, so what does the pickup sound like? I shall put the mic down, and as I said, there's a wee bit of reverb on this as well. That was Love in the Gardens of Rio, at least the start of it, from my latest album, Sounds Spanish, available on cdbaby.com. Right, So that's this particular guitar. It's very comfortable to hold. I should say that. And as a concert guitar, it's not bad. It's not bad. This retails in the UK about the £200 mark, usually under that. And I have beside me here, at roughly the same price, a Cortez guitar. So I'll just swap them over at the moment. Now here is the Cortez. Now this is a full-size classical guitar, solid cedar top. The Ibanez is a laminate top there, and as you can see, little B-band pickup preamp there, two-piece back. This is actually beautifully made. It is a thing of beauty. At what does it sound like? And of course, this is a full depth. So again, just through the microphone. A crisp sound, maybe a wee bit crisper than the Ibanez was. Again, that chord that straddles the 12th fret. What does it sound like? Sounds even better when you play it on the right fret, doesn't it? But you can hear the... Everything's right up there. So tuning-wise, full marks. You can't fault it at all. Again, a little bit of country. Now, what does that sound like when we put the pickup on? This time you've got a bit more to play with. You have volume, treble, middle, bass, presence control, and a tuner built in. Tuner is obviously really handy. What you're hearing is all the controls halfway except the presence, which is totally off. There's a wee bit of buzz at the high end, but I find that you don't really need the presence control. That could be down to my situation, you know. This is not a recording studio, this is my bedroom, you know, that's it. So, microphone off and the pickup on. Guitars, different characters to them. Certainly the Ibanez scores on comfort. It's very much the slouch on the couch instrument, but as a recording tool and as for live performances, yeah, this would probably be the weapon of choice. In fact, my album that I mentioned earlier on, plug, I actually used this guitar to record the tunes on it, so you can have a look at that if you feel so inclined.